Hello everyone, today we're going to be talking about how to assemble your own personalized sketchbook. To begin with, the materials that you need are quite simple. You're going to need paper. I like to use 11x14 computer paper just because it's a good practice sketch paper and it gives us a nice size sketchbook. You're going to need tag paper. For this, because we're using 11x14 paper, I have tag board or poster board that has been cut to 9 inches by 8 inches. You need scissors, a pencil, thread, thicker thread, and then a large needle. I use, for this lesson I have us using tapestry needles, along with a ruler. So let's get started. We're going to begin with our pencil, ruler, and paper first. The tag board and all these other materials will go off to the side. So you're going to need about 12, 14, or 16 of these larger pieces of paper. The more pages you have, obviously, the more pages of your sketchbook you will have. So you're going to fold them in half. You cut your paper in half like a hamburger, horizontally. Okay. You're going to line your corners up. You're using your thumb. Push down the seam. You're going to do that in sets of two. Okay. And the reason we're doing it in sets of two is because it's easier for us to poke our needle through sets of two rather than larger, thicker stacks of paper. So once you have your two pieces together, put one inside the other, and then you have one of your sets. You're gonna do this for all 14 to 16 pieces of paper until you have the desired amount of sketchbook sets that you want. So I have now three unfinished ones right here. The next thing we're gonna talk about is the binding piece right here. Okay, this is our binding marks, where we're going to put our needles through. Now, to do this, we need an edge. Okay, we need an edge that our pages can fold along. Okay, like this. We don't want our thread to go right here at the corners of the seams, because it will most likely rip. We want to give it a little bit of barrier before it hits the fold of our paper. So to do that, we're going to use our ruler, line up the fold with the inch mark on your ruler, and make a small pencil line at the half-inch mark, whatever, the bottom of your paper, same thing. Zero lines up with the fold, make a mark at the half-inch mark. Then, using your ruler, you're going to connect these two lines right here, giving us a guideline. This is where all our needle marks are going to go, this line right here. Okay, so now, how far out do we space these? For this, I like to have my sketchbooks go on about 2 inches on each side and then get a little closer towards the seam. I find the bottom and top don't need too much extra binding. Right. So I'm going to line my ruler up. Zero marks now the top of my sketchbook page. I'm going to do a mark, as I said, 2 inches in, so 2 inches in. My paper is 8.5, so that means I'm going to mark at 6.5. I'm going to come in 1.5 inches. 3.5 in, and then at the 5. And you're going to do these marks for all your paper sets. Alright, now that you have these edges marked, okay, these little dots are going to become your markers for the needle holes. So using one of our, again, we're using a thicker needle, a tapestry needle, you are going to poke your needle through the paper at each one of these marks. You may need to wiggle the needle just a little bit to help it go through. Now we need to get our thread. So I just chose to use red thread, just so it would be more visible in the video, but you all can choose whichever thread you would like to use. You need it to be about 2 arm lengths, so it looks about good. So it's about like 2 feet. Put the extra thread away. And our tapestry needles, again, are also larger, since the thread we're using is larger. They have a bigger eye or thread hole. and pull it down probably about 4 inches. Just so we don't, we're not likely to lose it. Now, to thread our books, we're going to start with 1, 2, 3, the third bowl down, okay? And sometimes it's easier to just pick up one set at a time. But we're going to start poking our needle through. So again, the third bowl down. Just so I make sure it's staying straight. And I'm going to pull the needle through. Again, you may need to twist and wiggle the needle to make sure it goes through all of your pages. Okay, now don't pull the thread all the way through. You want to make sure there's still room at the end for us to tie and knot when the time comes. Okay, so next, now, again, we're going to make sure that this stays forward. We are going to go back through that same hole. Okay, this time, again, from the top. You need to lift it up one page at a time. You can't. Oops, sorry if my head got in the way right there. Alrighty. So now we've created one loop. We're now going to go on the back of the books, and we're going to go to the second hole. It's going to look like this. So again, I'm working one page at a time to poke, or one set of pages at a time to poke my needle through. Just like with our last one, we're going to wrap around and go back through that same hole. Now we're going to go to the first one. And you might be wondering how in the world we're going to get down to this bottom loop. Don't worry, we'll get there. So I'm going to go to the first one, poke my needle through the pages. So this point you may have noticed now that we're missing some vertical pieces, the pieces of thread. So what we're going to do to help seal off this and make sure our book is really binding, we're going to go now over, back down to that second hole. Feed our needle back through it. You'll find that it's getting a little bit tighter to pull or to feed separate pages through. Sorry if my stuff is getting off screen. So if you find that you need to tighten it as you go, like I'm over here tightening, making sure it's nice and taut. Being careful not to pull too hard. All right, now I'm going to go back through hole number 3. Going over here to the last one. Okay, just like with the others, wrap around. Push back through your starting hole. Now that you're done, you should see that we just are missing one last vertical. This is where those two ends come into play. We're going to tie it together. And you can always trim down the edges if they're too big. And we have the interior of our sketchbook assembled. Okay, and what I'm doing right here is just kind of making a few folds along our nail holes, or thread holes, just so it'll be a little bit easier for us to turn the pages as we go. Now, the last thing that we're going to do is we need to mark, get ready to poke holes in our cardboard too. Now, to help us out, I am going to Now you can do a few little practice marks if you need to. I am going to though have us all use a hole puncher in case you all need this. If you don't, then you're welcome. The other way to help this hole come into place is also is either with a box cutter, which I can help you with as well. Alright, so our next last step is going to be marking where our nail holes go on our cover. Now, just like before, we're going to come in a half inch. So I'm going to do half inch in. Draw my line down. And then because my book cover is a little bit bigger, what I'm going to do is center the pages of my book, line up the folds, the edges of my book with the paper, the line that I just drew, and I'm going to make a mark where all the threads are, the thread is hanging off. Alrighty. The same thing with this page, come in half an inch. And as I said, to help you out, I can always come over and do a little starting hole with the blade. Or we can just do a really large hole with a hole punch. It's up to you. But the needle and thread don't go through it too well. You can keep with the same color thread if you would like, or you can choose a different one. You won't need quite as much thread this time around, but I'm still going to cut it the same way, just easier. Grab your needle. My needle through and then push it through the pages of my book as well. And before we tighten, we need to now go through the second page, the back cover. Go through there. And now this time around, we're not going to do a wraparound. We're just going vertical lines going through. And we're going to do that twice. Second one down. Now I'm just tightening and pulling a little bit of extra thread through. And then to make sure it's super secure, we're going to go back over and finish off the vertical lines. And now you are tying together the two ends. Just helping to fold along that edge. But you got your sketchbook. Now you can decorate the cover however you choose. There we go. This is all of it. That was how to make it. Your very own sketchbook. Let's get started.